is our V4 setup. It comes all together in 17 different boxes. These four packages are our structures. These are our motors, benches, and other equipment. So four benches, rotor molded, solar panels, a thing pack.
Thank you. चलिए
वंस वायरिंग हैज बीन डन देन वी सी हियर दिस जॉइंट दिस वाई कनेक्टर्स एज यू कैन सी दे हैव टू इनपुट्स वन इज फ्रॉम दिस पैनल एंड वन इज फ्रॉम पैनल ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड एंड वन इज पैनल ऑन द राइट साइड These two are panels are clubbed together. This is the positive side of both the panels. This is the negative side of both the panels. We have paralleled them. They get paralleled through this cable. And ultimately, the result of this goes in here. And this is finally fed to the inverter. This is the inverter. This is the PV plus and PV minus. And this input has been taken from this pipe, as you can see. Now this pipe goes at this input and finally this PV power is fed to the MPPT section inside. Now we have two outputs, one is for critical load and one is for non-critical load. And accordingly we have mains input, MCV for critical load and non-critical load. So then we have two cables for this battery bank. The VRLA battery bank is here. This is 52H battery bank, 48 volt, and we have communication, ZigBee communication antenna here. This communicates with the energy meter. So once we connect the panel and the batteries, then we can switch on the mains input. The mains input, this wire has been connected to the mains via this energy meter. This is the terminal strip. From the terminal strip, we can extend the wire to the energy meter and from the energy meter to the mains input. For the testing purpose, we have provided the input mains through an extension board. The moment this is connected, you can see the power going and the pulse. And another part of the ZigBee, RS-485 to ZigBee, because this meter is RS-485 based. So ZigBee gets input from 485 and transmits the signal. Now both ZigBees communicate with each other and the result is fed to the Venus GX inside. We'll connect our computer with the Venus GX and then see the performance. Right. Now the critical load can be connected directly or through the distribution box, and non-critical load is for here we have connected the non-critical load directly and critical load through this distribution board. That we have simulated three phase here, but out of the three phases we have used only single phase because the inverter is single phase output, and presently the load is connected on the R phase. From the R phase it goes to the safety, that is ELCB or RCCB. And from here, we get these two MCBs at the output. Output of the distribution board is connected to the extension board. And from extension board, we can switch on and switch off the load. So now I'll connect the load. So this is the non-critical load and this is the critical load. Now you can see after switching on the MCB, we have power here and power is fed to the extension board. Now we can switch on the load and you can see the load running through batteries and inverter. So after this we can go to the monitoring. इसकी फोटो ले लो ये आदमी यहाँ पे गलती पाएगी
मैं नहीं हूँ ठीक है कर लो बंद
चलो हम अब खोल के दिखा दें बुला ले किसी को बाकी लोग कहाँ गए चलेगा छिरोड़ी बच गया अभी अजीत को बुला लो, ये काम और भी अभी यहाँ पे सारा वो भी करना है, अभी ये हटाने सारी चीज़ें जो लगी लगी भी छोड़ के जाएंगे संडे कल। क्या नंबर है मंजीत का?
मंजीत को बुला ले,
मंजीत और राजकुमार दोनों को बुला।
हाँ
यहाँ से थोड़ी छोड़ के चले जाएंगे रात।
और नरेंद्र को बुला ले।
हाँ देखिए बैठा तो बुलाई फटाफट बोल। हेलो मंजीत एक बार नीचे आना और राजकुमार जी को भी ले आओ। पेचकस ले, पेचकस ले, पेचकस। वाटर ड्रॉपलेट तो नहीं है ना?
नहीं
सूखा हुआ
है।
ठीक है ना?
ठीक है
मंजीत, वो सिस्टम बंद कर के इसका सिस्टम निकालो सारे प्लग्स।
Now we have to download a program called Victron Connect, and once you open the Victron Connect we have this Venus G-axis displayed here. So we connected
and these are connected through the same Wi-Fi.
Yeah,
for somehow agar khud ka hotspot bana ke karna ho to
basically we can connect it both ways. Now we can see here, this is correct. I have used this Venus as a hotspot.
Okay,
3C8.
So in laptop is connected to the Wi-Fi which is created by Venus.
Right,
and then it automatically shows. Yeah,
so we open this and we go to the remote console, and this is how the system is working right now. Since it is already past 4, so solar generation is quite negligible here because it's winters also, and past 4 p.m. we hardly get any output, and the batteries are being charged. Grid load is approximately and fed by the critical load is being fed by the grid because the system has been programmed that way. So we can go to the different configuration and see how we have configured the system. So we click here, go to the menu bar. And you can see in the device list, first part is MPPT charge controller. It's showing 91 watt right now, as we saw. PV section, this is the analysis of 90 watt, the current and the wattage and the voltage. This is the power. So after this, we can go to the inverter section. Inverter section is right now in the pass-through mode. Input current limit has been set at 16 amps. It's receiving the battery voltage, and state of the batteries are charged at 97%. So since the batteries are charged, inverter is also working in the, and this is the input parameters, input line voltage, current, wattage and frequency, and same is the output because inverter is in the pass-through mode. There are no alarms and system is working perfectly. Go to the notifications and second settings. Here we can set the general parameters. The general parameters like access level is user and installer, both can access. Remote support is on. Suppose if any requirement is there, then remote support can be provided.
कोई ऐसी चीज़ है जो सूर्य मित्रा को करनी पड़े?
सूर्य मित्रा
सिस्टम इज ऑलरेडी अप एंड रनिंग।
हाँ
कॉन्फ़िगर्ड अप एंड रनिंग।
या Then we have firmware. It will show the version of firmware which is installed here. So this is by default, we cannot change it. Date and time. Yeah, time zone has been set at Indian Standard Time. And right now this is the local time. And this is the UTC time. Germany. So here in case you want to, so first we have to select the time zone. There are different time zones available. So accordingly we connect our Indian standard time zone from the list. And similarly the time automatically takes once you go to the Indian standard time. So automatically it takes, in case some tweaking is required, then the cursor is here. We can move the cursor and check if any deviation is there. Like this, you can synchronize the timings with your laptop or mobile. Once you select, then it's on OK. So this is the date and time settings. This is the remote console. So VRM portal is enabled, as you can see here. In case you feel it is off, you have to switch it on. So remote control status is offline right now because we are not connected to Wi-Fi. So once you connect to Wi-Fi, then this will be online. So we go to the system setup. So this is the system name. Since there was a batch of user defined name, we have used this is the system serial number 18 out of the lot of 30. Okay, then the input is grid, second input could be generator, and the battery monitor is being done here through inverter. State of the charge, and these are the default parameters. We cannot change. It doesn't have DC system, so it has been kept off. Then DVC is on. Shared voltage sense and current sense. Yes, as the battery bank is 52H, we have set the maximum charging current limit at 5 amps. You can vary through this plus and minus signs as per the battery requirement. We go to the our set value of 5. This is okay for us. Then, since it doesn't have any BMS control, this is for lithium-ion batteries. It has been kept off. And battery measurements can be done. Of course, this is for the BMS. So, battery measurements are presently done by, and this would be visible. So, after the system setup, online portal. Portal is on as we saw. It has been shown. This is the data logging time. You can change it. There are various options enabled. So if you want to log data 1 minute or 5 minutes or 10 minutes or 15 minutes, default value is 15 minutes. However, for testing purpose, we have put it at 5 minutes so that we have more number of entries. This is the portal ID where we got selected and logging has been enabled. Okay, since it is offline now, so it's showing like DNS is not connected at the moment. After this is an SSS, EWS. You can select the mode. This is presently we have selected optimized with battery life. We have options. But this is the default value as given to us by GIZ. Grid meter has been installed. Inverter AC input is in use. We have stopped, we have disabled feed in excess solar charger power to the grid. This is the phase compensation and these are the default values. Inverter power can be limited, so we have limited to 2 kilowatt because that's the rating of the panels. Schedule charging, you can schedule your charging like it has been disabled right now, but once you enable it, you can set when do you want to charge the time as per power conditions in your area. You can have the start time of charging or stop and duration of charging. Let's say you want to charge the batteries for 6 hours or 8 hours or 10 hours depending on this. And once the system has been achieved state of charge, the charging can be stopped. So I enable it. This is the SOC limit. 95% when it is achieved, you can stop. So this configuration, this schedule can be saved. So like this, you can have number of schedules. So you can schedule your charging characteristics through ESS. Then we have energy meters, PV inverters, Ethernet, and this is the Wi-Fi. So access point has been created, and this is the list of Wi-Fi's enabled. Right now, ground floor, since we are at a different premises, we don't have access to this Wi-Fi. Once you go inside the building, we'll have access, and then it can be configured. So for configuring, I'll show you. Once you enter the menu, this is the connect to the network. SN signal strength is very low. MAC address, IP configuration, you can set it automatic. Or in case you have manual data with you, you can set it to manual. But usually automatic takes it.
So this is basically you can connect ZigBee Wi-Fi, ZigBee to any Wi-Fi.
Yeah.
And then the laptop can also be connected to
Wi-Fi. Once this takes up Wi-Fi connection, once Wi-Fi is connected through this, so we disable this hotspot and work through Wi-Fi to the portal. So the moment we have the signal strength more than 50%, it will get connected. So presently, since we are at the remote location, it's not able to connect. Signal strength is very weak. So this is another Wi-Fi, another Venus installed there. So here signal strength is better, so it has been connected, but it is close to that building. Okay. So we go inside the building and connect it.